Hey everybody, it's Invicta, it's time for an Isaac run here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Rebirth series, but before we get to that, here's your spoiler warning for the previous episode. If you've not seen the episode, please pause this video and go watch it now, otherwise in 3 seconds, I can, shall, and will be spoiling it for you. Go do it! Pause now or forever be spoiled. So, man oh man, that Eve run was domination to the maximation. We're on a 90 game winning streak and I am okay with that. Horror Babylon's good, man. It's real good. Here's the seed today. It's going to be Whiskey Charlie Echo 1 42 X-Ray Whiskey. So again, I'm recording these kind of part of my backlog as I get ready for the Los Angeles trip to take part in the Mayhem Begins event for the launch of Here's the Storm. Super duper excited. Can't wait. Only downside? Well, there actually really isn't a downside, but I guess if I had to choose one thing that is a little bit... mold breaking, I guess, routine breaking, is that I do have to have a little extra heavier load of videos to record for the channel here. Of course, everything that I do, I make sure that I do it for you all here on the YouTubes. And one of that such things that I just alluded to is making sure YouTube content does not suffer or stop in any sort of way. So by the time you watch this, it's probably already safe to assume that I'm in Los Angeles, not back home. Right now, something I definitely would like to see leave my home are these spiders in Cellar 1. Now, we haven't fought the Haunt in quite a while, meaning that you know that we're going to be fighting him here. So I'd like to get at least to the item room to possibly get a little bit of help against him. Nice that we have full charge there for sure. And then two more skitterers. All right. I hate him. I hate him, man. There's nothing good about him. Absolutely nothing. The fact that they can move so fast, I think, is the most annoying thing about them, because they move faster than any other mob in this entire game. And they spawn extra spiders, which are just even more annoying and slow you down. I feel you, Isaac. I understand, man. Trust me. And we went the wrong way. We got Swallow Penny. Might as well take it. Swallow Penny is a trinket that will allow you to spawn a penny every time you take a hit. It's nice for a little extra damage, or a little extra money, I should say. Obviously, it goes very well with the blood bank, but we're not going to have one there. Why? Because we are on floor one, man. Unless if we get a temperance card, then we could theoretically get a blood bank. Again, if we do something like that, it's probably wise to not do it until after the boss is dead. Especially if we're going to be fighting you-know-who. Super excited about this weekend, though. It's going to be my first big trip since leaving for BlizzCon, actually. I gotta say, man, I'm a Blizzard fanboy. Mom's Eye, not good enough for me to take. Reroll. I'll take Thunder Thighs again, only because we're probably going to need the extra HP, but I think everyone knows how much I don't like moving super duper slow, which is what we're going to be, unfortunately, afflicted with right now. But the good news is that I am able to walk over these stones, so that's going to allow me to get extra money that I normally would not have been able to get. With the good old Stompy. Thunder Thighs HP upgrade gives you Stompy effect, which allows you to walk over debris. The downside, it slows you down by a lot. And I mean a whole lot. It's, I think, worse than Lard, actually, for the speed downgrade. And yeah, we're just gonna get killed by a spider and a fly. So now the Thunder Thighs upgrade doesn't matter. In fact, it actually hurt us because we're now moving slower because of it. So we've got to hope that at least there's maybe going to be a heart in here. Or maybe we find a crawl space, something like that. It's going to be a bomb to keep. Well, we might as well find out what is inside our good old shopperino. Half price bomb. And, yeah, I'm not interested in that. I am going to buy this red heart, though. The soul heart's interesting. May consider coming back to that, depending on what the boss drops. And I'm certainly interested in getting this golden chest down here. I could use a bomb to do that, but I probably shouldn't. If we get a third bomb here, I may. Instead of walking over the spikes. Getting the callus would also be kind of nice. There's a nickel. It's going to pay for a heart. Okay, so we could definitely spare the heart here, but first things first, let's see who our boss fight is. I don't have to tell you. You know who it's going to be. See? You would almost think that I'm like recording over like footage, but no. I just know it, man. I know when I'm going to be fighting him. It's been too long since we fought him. The game knew it. The game gave us, made sure that we got a speed down before fighting him. I feel it, man. I just feel it. You get the gitchy. Fighting the Haunt with speed down is about as bad as it gets in this game. We got out of there relatively okay. And now the real fight begins. Which sounds like a start to a very poorly acted action film. Important thing when fighting you-know-who is to make sure that you're crossing his middle threshold as quick as possible. He can't damage you if you don't stand in front of him. That's basically how it goes. And the trade-off is that you do have to deal with the split shot, that right there. But again, you want to be crossing the... You want to cross the vision of the Haunt as fast as possible while still dealing damage to him. Northern Lion definitely takes a more, I guess, bolder approach to fighting the Haunt. He gets up close and personal. If I have the movement speed, I don't mind doing that, but when we've got Thunder Thighs, not exactly going to be doing that. NL is just better than I am. There we go. Take him down. Matchbook, I will take, only to give us the bombs. And of course it would spawn two troll bombs there. So you may be asking yourself, well, what are you going to do with the full charge now? Well, the answer is I'm going to use it on the shop. There we go. And that key would have... That key would just have to go to the one spot that I couldn't get it on. Alright. I might as well use a bomb here to get this key. I mean, look, we've got Stompy. We know that we're going to be able to get Tinted Rocks whenever we want. That's fine. Yes, I have a good idea of where the cursor or the secret room is. It's right underneath this room, but still think that getting that second key is probably more important. So we're going to reroll slot machine. It becomes the little pill baggie. Little baggie, I should say. It was either buy the soul heart or buy the full charge and reroll again, and that's not something I want to do. The reason why I don't want to do that is because there's a chance that the pill, that the little baggie could roll again into itself. So we're done. Not a very good floor. 6.5 minutes down. Ugh. Positives: we've got HP. We've got a lot of money. We've got a trinket that's going to give us at least a little bit of value. Curse the blind. Let the good times roll. Look, I'm not shy about opening up low-level golden chests. I talked about it in some earlier episodes of Isaac Victor Rebirth. I just think that it's you're normally going to be okay. At the very least, you usually get back the key. Of course, it's not 100%, otherwise that'd just be a no-brainer for everybody. It's not 100% that you're always going to get your key back, but it does tend to work out where you do usually get a key back for your troubles. And if you don't, then, well, make sure that wasn't the last key sort of thing. So we have a double room here, which is interesting, especially if this is going to be a... If this is going to be like a five... If this is a five pedestal library, we could do some serious damage on this floor. I'm definitely highly motivated to see what's behind this double door. Let's go check it out. And it's a Three Skull Monty, which is, suffice to say, not what I wanted to see. If I had a bomb, I definitely would blow him up. This room is just god-awful when you have such low movement speed. Yep, nothing we can do about that one. Probably going to end up losing our soul heart here as well. Our evil heart, that is. We've already lost our soul heart. Sounds a good 5 cents down the drain, unfortunately. I was hoping that wouldn't blow up until he actually got there, but... It's alright. Now hopefully this yellow champion will drop us a full charge. And he did. Thank you very much, yellow champion. And we got the matchstick, which I am definitely going to be taking. That's going to give us a little extra bombs from our, I believe, chests. Could be wrong about that. It spawns a bomb after clearing a room. You have a chance to spawn a bomb. Either way, we need bombs, and I'm okay with that. Curse the Blind. It's going to be Lazarus's Rags. Tough. It's a tough call because damage is something that we're going to need. Lazarus's Rags don't give you speed, but they give you lots of damage. So the only way that we're going to make this work is if we get... if we are able to get an HP upgrade off of this boss. In a perfect world, we'll be able to get rid of our red heart HP for a deal with the devil, kill ourselves, and then come back as Lazarus and get an HP upgrade from the boss. That's in a perfect world. Now, that's probably not going to happen, but we can be hopeful. 29 cents. You bet your bottom dollar we're going to be checking out that shop. As soon as I'm done taking out that spider. We can buy both. Might as well. It's going to be Soul Converter, which is not something that I'm super thrilled about. Red Candle, also not something I'm super thrilled about. But we can buy that and re-roll it. We got the Blue Candle and 9 Volt. Okay. Not exactly an entire waste. It was just kind of a waste. We did get the 9 Volt. 9 Volt gives us a recharge. Unfortunately, we took it while we didn't have the D6. So we're not going to have a full charge here for the deal with the devil. Not that it's a big deal. Why? Because, man, it's Curse of the Blind. So it's not like we were going to reroll anyway. If we can get something like the Wooden Spoon, anything that gives us... I mean, I'll take Speed. Speedball is great. Roid Rage would be fantastic. Wooden Spoon. I'll set up anything that gives us speed right now would be most welcome, Monstro. I'm not gonna hate you for it, man. In fact, I'd love you for it. I don't know. Do you think that bosses dictate what they're gonna drop and what they're not gonna drop? I feel like if Monstro was in charge of what he'd be giving up, he probably would never give up Monstro's lung, because, well, he needs that to live. I like to think that we're not killing the enemies, we're just knocking them out. Monstro's not dead, he's just knocked out. Kill the devil! Well, again, Curse of the Blind, we have no idea what we're going to take, so let's find out. I don't want to take the 2-heart one, because it could potentially be Dead Cat, and that would be bad. So we get the mark, that's good. Dark Bomb, fantastic. Satanic Bible, pretty damn good. Pretty damn good. And we got Synth Oil, damage range up. Okay, so that could have been a lot worse. If we're going to kill ourselves, now is probably the best time, especially having Dark Bomb here. Let's see what's inside of our curse room, our boss trap room. I don't know, man. I don't know. Let's see what's in our curse room. We could kill ourselves and get ourselves out of the boss trap room. If this drops soul hearts, we're probably going to do the boss trap room and then kill ourselves, but that didn't happen. What is this? Guppy's Tail. It's a fantastic item. Dark Bomb, I tell you what. If you are able to produce one soul heart from this fight, we'll turn into Lazarus. Okay, well, I made a promise to Dark Bomb. I can't renege on that. There we go. So we are now Lazarus. We've got extra damage, we've got extra movement speed, and we don't have an extra life, but we're going to be dealing lots of damage, and I'm happy with that. Dark Bomb, consider my debt fulfilled. It's a risky play for sure, but again, with the lack of movement speed that we had, I'm okay with this. We get Blue Larry, which is good. We might even get another Soul Heart here, which would be nice. So yeah, that actually almost came out in a perfect world scenario way. We didn't get the HP upgrade, but we did get Dark Bomb. And that's probably better than the HP upgrade. Let's be honest, Dark Bomb is Dark Bomb. Alright, so we're going to have one more full charge here. We might as well use it on the Shopperino. And it's going to be, there's options. Fantastic, wow. Well, for Curse the Blind, that was a pretty damn good floor, I've got to say. We're coming away as Lazarus. We've got damage. We've got more options. The 9 Volt, 1 Guppy, Dark Bomb, Deal with the Devil Prestance, the Mark. You can't really ask for too much. It's Synth Oil as well? Yeah, you can't ask for too much more from one floor. All in all, one of the most solid floors I've ever seen for Basement 2. And again, remember, that was Curse of the Blind, too, so that was just all random luck. It's all you, Dark Bum. There you go, buddy. Thank you, Tom. And there it goes. All right. Well, sorry, Dark Bum. I'm an idiot. What can I say? He's like, I gotta work with this Yahoo over here. I'm sitting here trying to feed this guy options and keeping him alive, and he's just throwing it away on spikes. My bad, Dark Bum. It's late at night, man. What can I do? This is like video number 13 I've recorded today. I'm sorry. Lapse of judgment is going to be present. Luckily, this is the last video that I have to record today. And yeah, that would be a product of exhaustion right there. But I gotta do what I gotta do, man. I wanna make sure that YouTube has your content. Heaven forbid I don't put out one of my 3 daily videos. Definitely gotta be super careful here, because not only the mushrooms, but the bomb flies, the champion bomb flies could deal 1 full heart of damage to us, and that's not something that I want to happen. There we go. Justice, it's a fantastic card. Dark Bum not ready to pay out yet, that's alright. Oh, that yellow fly is moving, man. That's kind of scary. I need you to settle down a little bit. There we go. Alright, so we did get a full charge. Good. We know it's not Curse of the Blind because it's Curse of Darkness. I'd love to get Goathead. More HP, of course, is going to be very important. Our damage is going to be sufficient for the next 2 floors, and then it's going to start tapering off. Okay. I did that on the belief that there would be a key in here, game. And there's not. Makes me a little sad face. Piercing shots would be something that would be kind of a luxury, but would be most welcome right now. If I get a 1 room, would I reroll it? Probably not. We're in a good spot for damage, and I don't honestly want to lose Dark Bone. Yeah, I'm not going to be taking that. Oh yeah, we still don't have a key. And we still don't have a key. Alright, well, Judgment could give us a key. It's probably not the right wall to blow up, especially since I had a chance of revealing the super secret room, but oh well. Alright, Judgment, if you could just give us 1 key. Oh yeah, I'm an idiot. I forgot that we had Leo. Or, Thunder Thighs. I'm an idiot. Yeah, I've got to take that. There's no way I don't take HP right now. Black Gertie. It's an easy Gertie. Black Gertie Sr. only spawns flies. And spawns nubs. He doesn't shoot, so. Oh! Yep, there we go. So there goes the deal with the devil. It's really dumb how I don't think it's right that the flies can shoot through Gertie, but we can't. It's one of the things you gotta be paying attention for. And on video 13 of the day, the knee-jerk reaction reflexes are just not gonna be there. As long as we keep the streak alive, that's all that matters to me in the end. So we took 1 hit, probably ruined our deal with the devil, and it did. I'm not going to take either of these, I'm going to reroll both of them. Thank you, more options. Thank you, Dark Bum. Latch key, or we do need keys. Alright. I thought about not taking it, but it gives us soul hearts, it gives us keys. I can't really complain about not having keys and then not take keys. Flush, terrible item. There is a full charge over here, though. Now, the only question is, am I going to go through the big room? And I think the answer is probably not. I don't see any real reason to. If there's a curse room up there, maybe. It's Samson's Chain, which is completely redundant, considering the fact that we have the Stompy effect. I mean, look, we're not going to get Boss Rush. It's Caves 1 and it's 18 minutes already. We're not exactly blazing new trails here. I am interested in seeing what's in this golden chest over here. Let's go find out. There's a tarot card. I mean, it kind of saves us a key, I guess. You want to think of it outside the boxy sort of range. Alright, there's a curse room. Cool. Yeah, so there's no way in hell that I go through the big room now. Absolutely no point. Got our soul heart. We got our attack spider. We're good. So, not the best floor. We got well, two useless items. I mean, latchkey's good for a temporary item, but it doesn't provide you really with much else. We got HP, which is good. I could have had more HP, but I chose to reroll it for latchkey. Lost the deal with the devil on a very bad play, and we have no keys again. Hello, Mr. Dead Cat. Now we're starting to feel a little bit better about our situation. Two or three guppy items. We still have decent damage. We've got Dark Bum. Dark Bum means that we have longevity. We're Lazarus, so we know that we're going to be able to keep that damage, regardless if we die again or not. We've got the 9 Volt, which is going to give us a quicker charge on a spacebar item that isn't the D6. And yeah. Things are going good so far. Could be a lot worse, that is for damn sure. Yeah, we're still two-shotting hosts. Our damage is going to be pretty sufficient. I'll take that bomb. Oddly enough, we have not been in a deal or in a secret room. That was about as cheap as damage gets, gotta say. Alright, there's our key. There's our soul heart. Thank you, Mr. Bomb. I think, given the fact that our last two shots have not had greed in it, well, one of them couldn't have greed in it, but either way, probably just going to go to the item room. We already have a full charge anyway. Probably a good idea. Now, you may be saying, how come you just don't use the stars card? Well, it's because if we get a chance to go into a boss trap room, I'd rather be able to get out of there without having to do the boss trap itself. That's the reason why. Two soul hearts from one tin rock is beautiful. You know, seriously making a move, huh? Alright. Shoot yourself. There you go, Dark Bum. Oh, it's all you, bro. Bum friend, no. Peeper's eye, hell no. Alright, well. Thank goodness we were able to respawn as Lazarus, because we would have no health outside of the mark for damage. Unfortunately, this was the wrong way. Movement speed is still at kind of a premium right now. Thank you, Guppy's Tail. Take that as a sign. Guppy's Tail says, open more golden chests, and I say, sure. Have another key. Still don't have enough money to really make me think that the shop is going to be worthwhile, so let's open up another golden chest. And we got more money. Now, if we get access to the shop, then I'd be interested. Mildly acceptable. There's a dime there that I would be most happy of getting. Without causing damage to myself, if possible, please. There we go. Don't care about the other sense. Okay, so there's our boss trap room. That's the one that I'm not interested in staying in, but it's one that I'm interested in checking out. If there's an item pedestal in there, I definitely am hoping that we get Guppy. Guppy's tail, or Guppy's paw would be probably the best thing in there that we could see. And it's not going to be worth it. The only way that's worth it is if it drops a key, which we probably have a chance of getting another key soon. Have a reroll. I could go use it on Peeper's Eye. I think I'd rather use it to deal with the devil. This. A death card. Not very useful right now. Gonna be fallen. Okay, this could be very, very good. This could be exceedingly good, some might say. Alright, Fallen, I'm gonna need you to drop a Guppy item or drop a Pentagram, which would lead us getting a Guppy item in the deal with the devil that follows this fight. I'm gonna need from you, buddy. Come on, Fallen, be a bro here. You're not being a bro right now. Oh, there's our Guppy item. Can't pass that up. I would love to have Rotten Baby, but we did not get a deal with the devil. Reroll, and it's going to be Dark Matter, which I've already made. I've already said my piece about fear shots. If I have to take Dark Matter, it's not the worst thing in the world. I prefer not to, though. I almost ended up dropping a bomb there. I keep forgetting that we have the Stompy effect. Lovers, Fool card. Well, here you go, Dark Bomb. Strength card. Fool card. Alright, let's take the Fool card. And we might as well hope that we get a key out of the boss trap here. We didn't. We could have, but we didn't. We chunk the deuces to Chub, and that's gonna be it. So unfortunately, we got stifled by the fact that we don't have a key. Not that big of a deal in the grand scheme of things, especially since we're Guppy. But it would have been nice to get into our shop. Oh well, you can't always get what you want. I definitely need to go back and grab that Stars card, though. Yes, theoretically I could play the Sacrifice and maybe spawn a Gray Chest that gives us a key, but I'm not that worried about it. So we're going to take Dark Matter as a damage up, even though I hate it. Look, Fear Shots, so one day, Curse the XL, great, super happy about this. One day, YouTube nerds, you all are going to have to accept the fact that Fear Shot is just not very good. It's not very useful. It causes more problems than it solves. That's how I rate my items in Rebirth. If an item makes it to where I could possibly take more damage than necessary, I don't think it's worth it. And I don't think a fear is worth it, because it makes mobs very irregular. It speeds some of them up. And it, I mean, for no apparent reason at all. It's just not good. I don't like it. Some people love fear shots. I'm not one of those people. One thing I would love, though, is if we start getting some keys here. We've got good health. We've got damage because we're Guppy. All I'm asking for is a key. Moon card. Well, moon card would not be a key. Kind of useful, though, considering that August rune. That's going to be good. Let's take the moon card, and let's go see where our secret room is. Secret room's got two keys in it. Great. Fan-dabby-tastic. Where did Dabby ever come from? Dabby is not a name. I've heard of dab, like when you dab greasy food with a paper towel, in that context. But where did Dabby come from? Like, fan-dabby-tastic. Is that supposed to be a play on, like, on the name Debbie? Surely one of you nerds out there knows the actual answer to that. I had a feeling that would work out. Dry Baby, what's going on? Dry Baby, always a welcome addition to the party. Common Cold, not a big fan. Sack of Pennies, also not a huge fan. Let's go see if we can get something better. We're very lucky to have Guppy right now. Even luckier that we were able to fight the Fallen. On that last floor, got another key, which is going to give us access to the shop, or another chest. Golden chest, that is, which I am a-okay with. We might as well fight our boss now, just to see what it drops. Wheel of Fortune. No, thank you. Two of Hearts also doesn't really matter. Any war. Well, thank goodness we got more options, because having an orbital right now is not what we want. What we want is speed, tears, damage, anything, really. literally anything but an orbital. And that's neither. That's Steven and Ball Bandages game. That's not what I want. I will take the blue map, however. Also buy the key and the soul heart. Okay, so we have our reroll pedestal inside of the boss room. Pedestals, I should say. Small rock, fantastic. It's like Christmas, only better. By the way, small rock is just a straight damage upgrade, thanks to a little bit of luck, a little bit of skill finding a timid rock. Double our bombs, double our fun. It's gonna be more hearts, which kind of sucked, but got a soul heart out of it, so not gonna complain. Use the other stars card, and it takes us to Cricket's Head, which is amazing because it's a damage multiplier. And coupled with the fact that we're guppy, our flies are going to be, well, bombastic amazing. They're going to be fan-dabby-tastic. Now, dabby's going to be a word that I'm not going to be able to stop saying now, so just get ready for that, internet. Got an evil heart. I'm okay with that. I really don't like wasting our rerolls because we're on the wrong side of the map, but it's alright. It's okay. There could be worse things that could happen. That's for sure. Like getting Curse the XL. Hoping we get a Joker card here would be nice. Okay, we should probably do our best to try to not get rerolls right now. Thank you, Dry Baby. So if you're wondering why I bombed my way out of that room, it's because we're probably going to need another reroll. And I don't want to sacrifice too many charges just because we're on the wrong side of the map from the boss fight. So what I'm saying is that I'd like to try to save those charges that we could potentially get from clearing those rooms if we need it. At the very least, I'd like to have a reroll ready for the possible deal with the devil, which may or may not happen. It's unfortunate that there's no full charge inside of the shop right now, but let's see what we get from the reroll. Yeah, I think we have to take speed here. We were moving so slow after getting Thunder Thighs that our speed is still hilariously bad even after getting the belt. This is what our speed is right now. It's not very good. Again, damage is not really something that we truly need anymore. Especially with Cricket's Head Guppy. So now, we're going to check out the Super Secret Room and see if we can have a possibility of getting a deal with the devil item. Moon card, probably better than the Resistance Room, just so we can get out of the Mob Trap Room. Black Lipstick, yeah, we'll take it. Why not? Let's see what's in the Super Secret Room. Just a fortune-telling machine. It's not very good. Alright, we got a soul heart. Doesn't matter. There you go, Dark Bum. Sure, have another. Why not? I'm going to use the rest of this money to donate back into the donation box. But with this next reroll, maybe we can go back and reroll the sack of pennies. There's a curse room here as well. Let's go see what's in the curse room. And there's a full charge there. That's pretty nice that there is full charge. Alright. It sucks that there's two evil hearts in there, kind of, in a way. I actually have too much HP thanks to Dark Bomb. Not that that's a bad thing. I would prefer to have seen an item pedestal in there. Alright, reroll. Sack of pennies. Yeah, we'll go ahead and take Rubber Cement. Rubber Cement's hilarious with Guppy because the more times that it hits an enemy, the more flies are spawning. And that's pretty good. Now if we could get if we could just get a tiers upgrade, I would be happy. We should probably, even though this is a long, long way away, I think we should check what's inside of the Mob Trap Room. There could be an item pedestal in there. It's a very, very long run. The Eve run was already over by now. Poor Babylon would be something I'd love to see. Well, it's certainly an item pedestal, isn't it? I mean, I did ask for an item pedestal, so yeah, we'll take attack fly, whatever. Let's get the reroll ready for the deal with the devil, possible deal with the devil, and then that'll be it. I'm sure Abel would love to join us, but no thanks. I think we're okay without Abel. That was a trap if I've ever seen one. Stars card. Moon card might be slightly more useful in the womb, especially since we don't know where the stars card is going to take us, but not that worried about it. Alright, so we will have a reroll ready to go for the deal with the devil. If we get one. Not guaranteed that we'll get one. It's possible, but not likely. So let's go hit up the donation machine real quick, and then we'll go fight Mom. And that'll be it. Alrighty, well. Thanks for that. I might as well try to play for a little bit more keys. If we get one key out of this, I'll be ecstatic. And we didn't. That's alright. Good attempt anyway, I guess. Slot machine that I randomly spawned. So much damage. We did get deal with the devil. And, well, I asked for the pentagram, and I'll be damned if we didn't get the pentagram. Alright. I'm okay with this. More damage is nice, especially when we have a damage multiplier in Guppy. We are sitting pretty. Actually, not something I recommend doing if you have Stompy inside of the womb. You don't want to randomly be breaking red blocks. It's a good way of getting yourself hurt. As they do have a nasty tendency to explode every now and then. Eternal Eye Laser. That's just kind of mean, game. Two Soul Hearts is nice, but not needed. Let's just be silly. I don't mind being wasteful here with health because A, we've got Polar Invincibility, and B, well, quite frankly, there's Soul Hearts everywhere. Life is not something I'm too worried about right now in this run. Thank you, Dry Baby. And we did get a full charge, which is nice. Hermit card. One and the same with our Stars card. It's going to take us to somewhere random. You may be wondering why are we taking Liberty Cap. It's because we have a chance to at least proc Skinny on Mushroom. And if we can proc that on a boss fight like Isaac or Blue Baby, then it's all worth it. I love how Liberty Cap has become kind of like a top tier trinket now. And in no way am I insinuating that I'm part of the whole I think Liberty Cap should be considered a good item movement. But I have been a very big supporter of Liberty Cap for a very long time. Alright, Dark Bum's just going to have a field day with us. There you go. Thank you, Dark Bum. Glad you had fun. Conquest, everyone's favorite turd in Punch Bowl. In the other Punch Bowl, anyway. Didn't get a deal with Devil. Kind of unfortunate. Reroll. Toothpicks, yes sir. And honestly, I could go back and get the full charge, but I just don't think we need it. We very rarely ever get an item pedestal to work with on womb 2. Money, not really worrying about that. The nice thing about having blue map is that I can reasonably dictate, or at least somewhat accurately predict the... Yeah, we'll definitely take Rusted Key. I can somewhat accurately predict the location of the boss based on where the Super Seeker Room is. Now, it's not always set in stone like that, but most of the time, if you know where the Super Seeker Room is, you know exactly where the boss is. Rusted Key is going to help out with our key situation a little bit. Hopefully, anyway. It was a trinket that was completely non-working in vanilla, and it's been fixed. Increases the likelihood that you will basically spawn a key. Like that. I'll take it. You know what, Dark Mom, you had your fun in the last room. We don't need you. If we need help, then sure. Man, I'm not trying to bite the hand that feeds, Dark Bum. Please don't think that I'm trying to be ungrateful for your services. I'm eternally grateful for your services. It's just that I don't think we need to sit here and wait for you to pick up an entire room of red hearts when we don't need any HP, sort of thing. I still love you, though. I'm not trying to bite the hand that feeds, okay? Curse the Lost. Let's use our Stars card. Have no idea where that's going to put us in relation to the map. Maybe it put us next to Isaac. Maybe it didn't. It probably didn't. Thank you, Rusted Key. I'm just going off of what feels right. Right now, it feels like going southwest, I'm assuming, is probably going to be right. Who knows? Thank you, Dark Mum. Tenant Rock over there. There's a curse room over here, too. I love Rusted Key so much. It solves so many of our problems. Okay, apparently you can't shoot bombs with rubber cement. Good to know. I did not know that. This is one of the worst rooms in the cathedral, actually. I said that before when we came here, and I said it again. It's one of the worst rooms in the cathedral. Two Greeds and Fistula in the same room. It sounds like the beginning stages of a good joke, but it's actually not. It's anything but joke. You can get killed in that room. I have been killed in that room before. On this show, I might add. I'm not sure why my flies were being so lackadaisical there, but we need to be careful with our damage. Or our health, anyway. Our incoming damage. Isaac should be a breeze with the amount of damage that we have from our attack flies and rubber cement. Dry baby just adding on a little extra damage, but yeah, we're gonna be completely fine against Isaac. Thank you, Dry Baby, for doing what you do. And yeah, I could go back and go pick up some soul hearts, but I have a feeling that we're gonna be okay. We're doing alright, let's put it that way. Infestation. Prayer card. Ipecac. And my reflection. Yeah, we're gonna just reroll all of that. Definitely take Cricket's Body. Definitely take Tough Love. Definitely not take Dr. Fetus. I'll touch Telepathy for Dummies, but I'm not gonna keep it. Now our damage starts to get a little out of control. Now is when we can start celebrating our damage. Cricket's Body just makes it even more ridiculous. I mean, it's nowhere near the level that we were at in the last run, but it's pretty nice. Mini Mush, absolutely. Alright, man, it looks like Blue Baby's just right around the corner, man. It's gonna be a very quick chest. What's this? Empress card. Sure, why not? So, at the end of the day, we end up getting a win. Not all that surprising, to be quite honest. I mean... It was scary in the beginning there, but we did get some help, thanks to Mr. Darkbum. Honestly, the MVP goes to that blind, that Curse of the Blind floor that we had before, too. The fact that we were able to get so much for so little was beautiful. And, of course, Lazarus' Rags also helped. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you next time for an Eden Run. But until then, so long, everybody.